The President. Government Bills. First reading. Court Proceedings Electronic Technology Bill. Employment Amendment Bill 2019. Second reading, Chief Secretary for Administration. Mr. President, I move the second reading of the Court Proceedings Electronic Technology Bill, thereafter called the bill. The bill seeks to implement the Information Technology Strategy Plan, ITSP, in the judiciary in phases so as to allow court users and additional option to handle court-related documents by electronic means across different levels of courts. After a long-term study on the use of information technology, the judiciary introduced a major IT upgrading project called the Information Technology Strategy Plan, ITSP, to respond positively to the rising expectations of court users and the community. Through the use of information technology, more effective and efficient services of a higher quality can be provided to all stakeholders. It can also facilitate active case management throughout the entire litigation or adjudication and ancillary processes to improve access to justice for the benefit of all stakeholders. Under the ITSP, an integrated court case management system, ICMS, which is an IT system, is to be implemented to streamline and standardize electronic court processes across different levels of courts as appropriate. In particular, to enhance access to justice, electronic services and facilities of various types will be introduced as appropriate as an additional option to the existing conventional channels, that is, paper-based means, to be used by court users on a voluntary basis. While the conventional approach is still available, the judiciary will encourage court users to interact with the judiciary and the other parties electronically to transact court businesses. The paper-based and electronic arrangements will be aligned as much as possible to ensure that the judiciary's operation will not be affected by the new mode of documentation. In drawing up the bill, we have carefully considered the principles and spirits of the administration of justice as set out in the existing legislation, and that they should be carefully balanced against the convenience resulting from the use of information technology. The judiciary will facilitate the use of electronic means without compromising the need to safeguard the interests or rights of the parties concerned and ensuring fairness of the judicial process and integrity of the documents or processes. The key proposals in the bill are set out as follows. 1. E-sending of documents to the court. In normal circumstances, electronic submission of documents for filing or sending to the court will be allowed. 2. Inter-party electronic service of documents. For service of documents between parties, a party can serve documents electronically on another party if there is mutual consent. And to allow flexibility, the two parties may agree among themselves on the most appropriate electronic platform to serve the documents. 3. E-authentication of documents. In normal circumstances, electronic forms of signatures for court-related documents other than traditional manual signatures will be allowed, such as digital signature and electronic signature. Point 4. Legal status of printouts. For some court procedures, there will be a need for a copy of an electronic document to be printed out for subsequent use. A common scenario relates to the service of originating documents for civil cases. After the bill comes into effect, if a plaintiff chooses to submit an originating document electronically, the court will apply an electronic seal on the document before sending it back to the plaintiff. If the defendant has not agreed to accept electronic service of documents, the plaintiff will have to print out the electronic document and serve the printout on the defendant. While the judiciary will provide an administrative cross-checking service to confirm whether the document has been issued, there may still be concerns on the legal status of the printout. Hence, the bill proposes to provide a proper legal status for printouts and copies of printouts for documents issued by the court. Mr. President, the bill also provides that the Chief Justice may, by e-rules or practice directions, specify the types of courts and tribunals in which e-documents may be used, as well as regulating the details and operational procedures on the use of information technology. Using practice directions will allow the judiciary to make timely amendments to the procedural details and rules in the light of rapid technological developments. ITSP will be implemented in two phases and will gradually be expanded to all levels of courts. The first phase will consist of two stages for better management. In stage one of phase one, the ICMS will be implemented in district court and the summons courts of the magistrates courts. In stage two of phase one, the ICMS is expected to be extended to the Court of Final Appeal, the High Court, and the remaining part of the magistrates courts, as well as the Small Claims Tribunal. For the remaining courts and tribunals, the ICMS is planned to be implemented under phase two. The judiciary has consulted various stakeholders, including the Hong Kong Bar Association and the Law Society of Hong Kong on the bill, as well as the Administration of Justice and Legal Services Panel of the Legislative Council. They generally support the bill. Mr. President, the bill will allow more timely and efficient communication between court users and the courts and between parties. In the long term, it will help reduce the use of paper and will also enhance the efficiency of litigation in Hong Kong. I urge members to support the bill. I so submit. Thank you, Mr. President. And I propose a question to you, and that is that the aforesaid bill be read the second time. In accordance with the rules of procedure, the second reading debate is adjourned and the bill is referred to the House Committee.
Secretary for Labour.